Hey everyone, Tech Katsonis here for CDN, Computer Dealer News, here at the Consumer Electronics Show in Las Vegas. And what everybody's talking about are tablets, and even more tablets. We're going to go in and take a look at some of these.
RIM's BlackBerry Playbook was hotly anticipated at the show, and the new operating system and user interface seemed to blend promisingly well, making it more responsive on its 7-inch screen than other touch-based BlackBerries like the Storm and Torch. The software and hardware overhaul means better graphics, heavy multitasking, and the ability to piggyback off of BlackBerry Phone's 3G connection. RIM executives are tight-lipped about launch plans and pricing, though, so time will tell. Motorola's Zoom tablet looks to be a promising entry into the category. It sports a 10-inch screen, runs on Google Android 3.0, otherwise known as Honeycomb, and is powered by a speedy dual-core processor. The intriguing combination helped the device win top honors as the best gadget at CES, and availability in Canada could come as early as the spring or summer. Meanwhile, Samsung already owns a piece of the tablet market with the Galaxy Tab, but it's looking to experiment with different form factors like this one here. The sliding tablet PC7 series slides out the 10-inch screen to reveal a full keyboard, thereby turning the device into more of a notebook. It runs a full version of Windows 7 with an overlay developed by Samsung to make the interface more tablet-friendly. This may hit store shelves in Canada sometime this spring, though nothing is confirmed yet. Dell will be launching the Streak 7, adding to the family of tablets born from the 5-inch model released in Canada in November. The new Streak won't run on Honeycomb, which is the version of Android designed for tablets, but will instead use Android 2.2, which is also known as Froyo. Dell will also have an overlay they call Stage, for a distinguishable look and feel to the tablet as well. Availability in Canada is likely coming sometime this year, though no actual time frame has been set yet. Asus showed four different tablet designs, one of which includes a 7-inch Android model falling in line with most of their competitors. Two of note are the E-Pad Transformer and E-Pad Slider, both of which include keyboard elements to their design. The key difference is that the tablet part of the Transformer can be unattached from the keyboard, while the Slider is a slide-out keyboard like Samsung's model. The oddest of the four was a 12-inch tablet running Windows 7 that can also work with a wireless keyboard. Details on Canadian availability aren't known right now, but at least one or two of these models could be in stores sometime this year. This year's CES was undoubtedly tablet-heavy, but it seems that the sweet spot may be the 7-inch models that offer more portability. Processor chips are a mix of NVIDIA Tegra and ARM as well as Qualcomm, depending on the make and model. PC stalwarts like Intel and AMD are also expected to join the fray in this emerging category.